Welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. Today is Sunday, August 19th, 2018. This is the 13th Sunday after Pentecost. Today our pastor is Pastor Carol Gesalman. Pastor Pollock is on vacation this week. St. John's is located at 27 North Wittenberg Avenue, Springfield, Ohio. Our telephone number is 937-323-7508. Our 8 o'clock service is at the Melody Cruise Drive-In, east of Springfield on Route 40. There are two more services there next Sunday and Labor Day weekend. Labor Day weekend, September 2nd, will be the pet blessing. Everyone should bring their pets and it will be blessed. And then 8 o'clock services will resume back in the sanctuary in downtown Springfield on the following Sunday, September 9th. St. John's has a food pantry open Wednesdays 9 to 10:45. On Wednesdays, outreach store open Monday through Friday 9:30 to 1, close on Thursday. Rainbow table is every Friday from noon to 1. And also with you.
Today is the 13th Sunday after Pentecost. And I don't have a personal mic on because the configuration of the mic here doesn't work with long hair. So I will try to be by the mics or I will be standing here yelling. In our service, in your bulletin, there is a hymn 818 immediately before the sermon. But there's another
we confess that we have turned from you and given ourselves into the power of sin. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things we have done and things we have failed to do. Turn us again to you and uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As they call an ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Set us free to be people of God.
Your Son gives himself as living bread for the life of the world. Fill us with such a knowledge of his presence that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life to serve you continually through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Our reader today will be Harvey Baker.
First reading is from Proverbs. Wisdom has built her house. She has groomed her seven pillars. She has slaughtered her animals. She has mixed her wine. She has also set her table. She sent out her servant girls, she calls, from the highest places and big town. You that are simple, turn anew. To those without sense, she says, come eat of my bread and drink of the wine I have mixed. Lay aside the journey and live, and walk in the ways of insight.
Words. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. And Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate when they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Disciples come to understand and are distributed to those who eat in the supper of the Lord. Truly present does not mean that the bread and wine become body and blood in the physical sense. They still taste like bread and wine. And if you analyzed them in the lab, they would still show the properties of bread and wine. Nor does truly present refer to the flesh and blood of the dead man. But instead, truly present refers to the presence of the living Christ, since death has no dominion over him. In the Small Catechism, Luther describes Holy Communion as the true body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ under the bread and wine given to us Christians to eat and to drink. In his Large Catechism, Luther wrote, the body and blood of Christ is described as being, quote, in and under, end quote. Later, if you remember your catechism, you learned it's in with and under. All of this is an attempt to describe what is really indescribable. We believe that the common substances of bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ when Christ's words are spoken over them and believing Christians gather to receive them. They are the body and blood because Jesus said they are. This is my body. This is my blood. Now, what's the benefit of this eating and drinking? What do we gain from it? Article 13 of the Augsburg Confession states that the sacraments, meaning baptism, communion, and at that time absolution, are intended to awaken and confirm faith in those who use them. Luther's Small Catechism lists the benefits as, quote, forgiveness of sins, life, and salvation. All three are benefits because, quote, where there is forgiveness of sins, there are also life and salvation, end quote. We know that the forgiveness of sins is a benefit of partaking in the Lord's Supper because Jesus said, drink it, all of you, for this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. Now, it's true that our sins are forgiven at the time of our baptism. We are washed clean that day and enter into a new life with Jesus Christ. Problem is that we are still human. The world and the devil offer up many temptations. Often we grow weary and faint. At times we even stumble. The Lord's Supper is given to us as daily food and sustenance, so that our faith may continue, even grow stronger as we face the daily struggle. Of course, we've lost the notion of celebrating communion every day. We don't even celebrate it every Sunday. So until that time, when we begin to realize the importance of offering the meal more often, I will say that if you need to feed your faith or remind yourself of God's forgiveness or feel the presence of Christ in a very tangible way, and it's not time for communion, talk to your pastor and ask him for it. We should be offering communion every time we gather in worship because we never know when someone needs more than just the spoken word. Augustine called the sacrament of Holy Communion a visible word, and so it is. So when our service ends after just sermon offering and prayer, we should feel as though something is missing. The Lord's Supper is a treasure given to us, Jesus' disciples. It is daily sustenance for our struggles in this life. It renews and refreshes our faith. It forgives our sins. sacrament of Holy Communion. The Lutheran Church welcomes anyone who is baptized and who believes in Jesus Christ to the table. Luther said in the Large Catechism the following, as regards the communion of children, quote, since they are baptized and received into the Christian Church, they should also enjoy this fellowship of the sacrament so that they may serve us and be useful. Baptism admits a person into the Christian Church. Now, if you're baptized as an adult, you're welcome to the communion table immediately, but they receive instruction before their baptism. They're able to verbalize their faith. They can have some kind of understanding of bread and wine as body and blood. A newly baptized baby can't have had any instruction and can't verbalize any faith in Jesus as Christ. But as a baby grows, if the parents are doing as they promised with their child's baptism, he or she will learn of Jesus and can sometimes have amazing faith. They'll learn that the bread and wine of communion isn't just a mid-morning snack, but that it is indeed Jesus' body and blood. And it is then that they also should be welcomed at the table and share in the meal of all believers. Luther said in his explanations of the Augsburg Confession only that in using the sacraments, there must be a faith which believes these promises and accepts that which is promised and offered in the sacrament. In the Small Catechism, Luther says simply, he is truly well prepared who believes these words for you and for the forgiveness of sins. All who believe and are baptized are welcome at the Lord's table. And all are to come receive communion on a regular basis. Some people think they don't need the gift. They feel that they're too good to need it. These people need to understand that as long as they're in this world, they are full of sins and needs, and therefore in need of Jesus and his forgiveness. Other people may feel too unworthy to receive communion. These people need to know that this sacrament does not depend on their worthiness. The more we sin, the more we are in need of forgiveness. And if we don't feel our sinfulness, then we're in need of communion even more. The scripture tells us that we're full of sin, and scripture does not lie. Remember the shovel old lady and the sobbing young woman in my opening story? The older woman knew her need for communion. The younger woman wasn't sure she was worthy. Thankfully, the old lady noticed and invited her to join her, saying only that the meal was especially for both of them. When our meal is prepared today, come and share in it. Come and experience Christ among us. Come and taste forgiveness. And praise God, who loves us still.
Amen.
God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things seen and unseen. We believe in the Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the world of the world to come. Amen. Hear our prayer.
O Lord, bless the work of musicians, composers, writers, and all artists. Move us to even greater praise through their gifts of creativity. We thank you, Lord, for this beautiful, artistic church that leads us to you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Hear our prayer.
O Lord, send calm and perseverance to those who are in trouble or who live daily with great stress. Fill them with your spirit and satisfy them with your presence. We pray especially for Brandon, Julie, Sally, Mary, Riley, Hannah, Emma Lou, Mike, Connie, Jeremy, Jeanette, and all of those ill that you do not know about. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O Lord, we thank you for this congregation. Give us gratitude for the many blessings we enjoy and inspire us to give thanks at all times. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we bless you for family, friends, and sisters and brothers in Christ who have guided us in wisdom and insight. Lead us in peace with all people until the day of Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Almighty and loving God, we look to you in hope and trust, knowing that you will do far more than we can ask or imagine. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen. It's time for our offering. Ted and Helen Wallace are our ushers today. Mm-hmm. Amen. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you. Amen. Amen.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen. Concludes our service for August 19th, 2018. Again, join us next Sunday at the drive-in on at the Melody Cruise drive-in on East 40, east of Springfield. The following Sunday on September 2nd will be the pet blessing at the drive-in, and then 8 o'clock service will resume September 9th here in the chapel, in the sanctuary at St. John's. St. John's is located at 27 North Wittenberg Avenue, Springfield, Ohio. Our telephone number is 937-323-7508.